Hello everyone, I am Dr. Priya Kanojia. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn about population density. Here in this image, you can see crowded people in an area. Like this, the world population distribution has been shown with the help of pink color dots. In this map, each dot represents settlements about 200 persons per square kilometer. You can see two color circles, red one and blue one. Blue color circle shows the higher density of population and red color circle shows the lesser density of population. Blue color circle shows higher density of population as there are more number of dots. If there are more number of dots, then there is a higher density of population, and lesser the number of dots, lesser the density of population. Here is the population distribution of India. In this map, orange color shows the population distribution about 10 crores and yellow color shows the population distribution below 10 crores. This map shows the population density of India with different blue color shades. In this map, darker the shade, higher the density of population, and lighter the shade, lesser the density of population. So with the help of these type of maps, we can easily recognize the higher density and lower density population regions. So what is population density? As we all of know that human population is unevenly distributed throughout the world. In 2019, world population is about 7.7 billion. So let's have a look on the continent-wise population distribution. So in North and South America, 28% landmass supports the 18% of the population. Asia has 30% of the landmass and supports 60% of the population. It means double population than the landmass. Europe has 7% of landmass and supports 5% of population. Australia has 6% of landmass but does not even support 1% of population. Antarctica has 9% of landmass but has no permanent human settlement. So with these statistics, we can easily conclude that there are some factors which affect the population distribution. Let's have example of Antarctica. See, Antarctica has 9% of landmass but does not support any permanent settlement. Why? It is because of extreme cold climate. Let's see the definition of population density. So population density simply means how crowded or uncrowded a particular piece of land is. The distribution of land and population can be better understood in terms of people living in a unit area. Population density is calculated with the help of total population divided by total area in square kilometer. Let's have example of Maharashtra. Maharashtra has 11.24 crore population with an area of 3,07,713 square kilometers. So with the help of this formula, if we calculate the population density of Maharashtra, then it comes around 365 persons per square kilometer. Here are some examples of population density. So dense population density regions are China, India, USA and Europe. Moderate population density regions are mostly the grasslands of the world. So prairies of USA, belts of Africa, downs of Australia, savannas of Africa. And low population density regions are probably desert regions and polar regions. So, with these points, we can conclude that physical factors like terrain, climate, availability of water and soil influence the population distribution around the world. And that's all for this session. I hope you found this video informative. Thank you for watching.